Hi, I'm Todd Soans. Obviously, there's a lot of demand to learn about belly putting because of what's going on tour. There's so many players that are switching or have been belly putting successfully, there's a great interest. Now here's what's going to happen. The average amateur is going to walk into a golf shop that's interested in belly putting, and they're going to have a choice of a 41 or a 43 inch belly putter. That's ridiculous. Belly putting has to be fit, absolutely fit, to make sure that someone's set up properly so that you can actually try the technique. If a belly putter doesn't fit you, it really won't work. Let me explain why. The first thing to understand about belly putting is it's absolutely the same as conventional putting if your setup is correct. You see, if I take my conventional length putter, which is 32 inches, it doesn't look any different when I'm over the golf ball than if I have a belly putter in my hand. There's four things that we look at as far as fitting putters. The first is, you should tilt forward from your hips so that your eyes come to rest over the golf ball. The second is your hand should come to rest directly under your shoulders with your elbows connected and kind of attached to your rib cage. The third point is your hips come to rest over your heels so that your weight is positioned on the balls of your feet. And the fourth point is the shaft of the golf club, the putter, should really be in alignment with your forearms. So when you look at belly putting, it's exactly the same four fundamentals. My eyes are over the inside edge of the golf ball because I'm tilted from the hips. My hands are directly under my shoulders. My elbows are tucked in and connected to my rib cage. And the shaft of the belly putter is going right through my forearms. So really, from the side view, you can't tell if someone's belly putting or conventional putting because it should look identical if the setup is proper. But here's the catch. The putter has to fit the player. Because if someone has a belly putter that's too long, it will push them out of those positions. Let me demonstrate. Here's a belly putter that's set too long, and it simply pushes me up. So now I can't tilt enough to get my eyes over the golf ball or my hands under my shoulders. So this is a belly putter that's too long for me. And then, of course, a belly putter that's too short has the opposite effect. It forces the player to bend over too much. And at this point, now the belly putter sits too low where the hands are inside of the shoulders and the eyes would tend to get past the golf ball. The way that we fit for belly putters using the TriFit tool is you first determine the conventional length that the player would need in the proper setup. So for me, what the tool does once I set up to it is it's measuring from the butt of the golf club straight down to the ground. And then, of course, the TriFit method, my eyes come to rest on the mirror. So that simply equates to a 32-inch, when we calculate that, that equates to a 32-inch conventional length putter. Now, the neat thing about the tool is we have an extension on it. So if I get set up, figure out conventional, I just pull the extension up, and you can see that that adds 7 inches to a belly putter. So for me, I simply need a 32-inch plus 7-inch length into my belly putter, so I need a 39-inch belly putter. So the proper length belly putter, I can set up exactly like we just talked about. I can take the putter, put it just left of my belly button, tuck my elbows into my rib cage, tilt, take my stance, and there's a perfect setup. So just remember this. If you're going to try belly putting, you have to see a professional that understands how to set you up properly and then measure you to a belly putter if you're going to give it a try. And if you do it, believe me, it's a great technique. It's helping a lot of players on tour, but it has to be done properly for it to work. Give it a try. It'll help you.